Dwayne brought me onto this project to try to help him get into this cavern. Well, obviously, after Chad found that box, I started to like this treasure angle.
Can you get that underneath there?
But not all treasure is buried in underground caverns. Iridium is a naturally occurring mineral that's more valuable than a box of gold.
Come on, Eric.
First, we'll do surface sample. This is nice red-looking material here.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
It's got some iron in it for sure. They say that iridium has an affinity for iron.
Is that right?
Yeah, hopefully it shows. So we've got three samples from all over the ranch. We got a surface sample from yesterday's hike. We got a sample from the meteor site. And we have a sample of the blue mineral that we pulled out of the energy zone.
I used to always be hoping for gold, but now I'm hoping for iridium.
All I can do is give them options, basically. And I'll give them that option to mine for iridium if we find it in significant concentration. So next, this is the blue zone, so we'll do the same thing. We're looking for evidence of a meaningful concentration of iridium, something that may explain the anomalies that go on around the property. And if it's that big, that means we can mine it. I like that. The last,
it's just a small sample, but
okay.
This is the meteorite wash.
Do the honors. Go ahead.
We know whenever we get that first snow and the weather starts kicking up, that we're getting close to the end of the season. I mean, I obviously want to go into the cavern and back to the box, but if we can find something else of value before we get snowed in, that'd be huge too.
So we got our sample there, that's our concentrate.
Okay.
Which will pan out.
Nice.
So first we'll do surface sample we took.
Okay.
Right off the bat, I'm not seeing anything. Now we'll do the meteorite sample. I don't see anything there. Let's see, now we'll look at the next one. This is the sample from the blue zone. I'm really hopeful for this sample here. Look at that.
Yeah, you can definitely see that.
It's a shiny metallic bluish thing.
Yeah.
Interesting.
There's two of them. Two pieces right there.
Two pieces.
What is that?
It could be iridium. If it is iridium, it's coming from somewhere. And so there could be a big deposit up there. If we find this load source of that, that's huge. Depending on the size of the deposit, it could be worth millions, tens of millions, hundreds of millions. It's that valuable. Yes, they're small, but having that many pieces in one spot is really, really significant. From a geology aspect, it's huge.
Eric found four flakes of something, and it might be iridium. So we're going to test them with the XRF gun and see how pure they are. But it's going to have to be a high concentration before we want to get into an iridium mining operation out here.
We ready?
Start her up. Parts per million iridium mineable, it's considered 10 parts per million.
So anything above like 20 would be amazing, right?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Come on, iridium.
Hey,
50. That's 50 parts per million?
61.
Yeah, let's
go. So it's still running.
Oh, it's
still running. It's going up.
87.
80 parts per million? Oh my.
The early stages of the process, it's coming up 80 parts per million.
We've got iridium, guys.
That was significant in itself. If it had ended at that point, I would have been very happy.
This is the full scan here. This is the final. Oh, 804,000?
And those specks are pure iridium.
It jumped up to 800,000? Like, what?
That's amazing.
That's unbelievable.
That's fantastic. You got it, man.
It's amazing. It shot high. It shot huge. I think Eric's onto something here.
We may have an iridium mine here.
That'd be all right. That'd be real good.
We're still a long ways from finding a mineable deposit, but that's very significant.
That's awesome.
I'm not giving up on the treasure in these caves, but we could be sitting on a huge iridium deposit.
We're on the trail, boys. Dwayne, you ready to become an iridium magnate?
That'd be a yes.
All right. I'll second that motion.
There you go.
One beer left.
It's gonna be hard to split.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, guys, I can feel the chill in the air. And our season's almost to the end, but I'm real happy. I'm happy about what we found. I'm happy about the potential. I'm a prospector. And so what I'm seeing are indications that you have something significant here. We have a mineable deposit of iridium. It could be worth millions. It could also explain why we've been seeing these weird things, the equipment malfunctions.
So iridium would do that then?
Well, it's a very dense metal, just like gold. Mm-hmm. So with a GPR or even resistivity, it could affect the instruments is what I'm saying.
So you think it would cause a lot of interference?
It could, yeah. There's still some question marks out there, but I think we've answered one very big question. Why are all of our electronics, drones, GPR, sound engineering equipment
in the basement,
camera system gone haywire? It's a very distinct possibility that iridium is causing this interference.
Well, I think we solved one part of it, but we still got a long ways to go.
Yeah, there's still a lot of discoveries to be made. Not only the treasure aspect, but the mineral. We know it's connected somehow.
That's the mystery of this place.
Yeah.
So here's the deal, fellas. See, it's high risk out here, but the reward is just overwhelming. And no risk, no fun. I hate to admit it, but I'm kind of one of those junkies, and I think I raised one just like me.
We've answered one big question, which is awesome. But for the next 6 months, I'm going to be dreaming about that box in that cavern, man.
Sometimes to do something very significant, you have to deal with a little bit of risk. But once in a while, you get that big payday.
Yeah. It's coming. Yeah. We're close.
Yeah.